Would you like to track the income for the billable expenses that you charge your clients? Well, then you should watch this video, Income from Billable Job Expenses. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. There are three ways to track or record billable expenses after you bill your client. You could track them as income in a common account called billable expense income. And that's what we learned in the prior video. In this video, we will learn how to track the income in specific accounts for each billable expense. And in the following video, we will learn how to track income from billable expenses simply as a decrease to the expense that we charged instead of as a separate income. Now, there are three steps to set up QuickBooks Online to be able to track billable expenses into specific income accounts. First, you will have to add the income accounts to the chart of accounts for the billable expenses that you want to track. You then must change the settings for the expenses to track the income from the billable expenses in more than one account instead of the default income account that we used in the previous video. And we know we changed the settings in the account settings window, just like we learned in an earlier video. You then must open the expense account in the chart of accounts that you want to bill as income, and then tell QuickBooks Online which income account will increase when that expense is billed to a client. And now, let's set up for our example. Let's imagine that we want the income from billable supplies to be recorded and shown in an income account called Income from Job Supply Sales. We must change the expense settings in the Account Settings window to be able to track billable expenses in different income accounts. So, we come to QuickBooks Online and we click the top right, the cog wheel, come all the way to the left of the menu, and in the top left, click Account and Settings. Now, the category of settings, we will click Expenses. And we were at this window in an earlier video where we have to open up this top section here by clicking the pencil. Now, right now, we are able to track billable expenses and items as income, because that was the way it was set up before. It was actually set up with the green button in a single account. What you have to do is click here, in multiple accounts. So mine was clicked here because I was playing with it before, but this is what you should have had by default. And when you click here, leave the green button here, in multiple accounts, and then click save. And that gives QuickBooks the ability to put the income in different accounts rather than the default account that we used in the previous video. Now, we must add the income account to our chart of accounts. Income from Job Supply Sales. Well, that's no problem. Close the account settings window. Go to the bottom left where it says Accounting, Chart of Accounts. Now we're going to add a new account by clicking in the top right, and this type of account will be income. And the subcategory can just be other primary income. Usually the detail type is not that important, but the name is the most important, Income from Job Supply Sales. And then, of course, We click Save and Close. Now, the third step is very interesting. The third and final setup step tells us that we must go and open the job supplies expense account and then tell that account where the income goes when we bill for this specific expense. We also do that in the chart of accounts. Stay in the chart of accounts and scroll down to the account that says job supplies expense. Here it is, job supplies expense. It's the one that we used in a previous video. Then click Edit. Notice this additional tab has been added down here after we activated this in the account settings window a moment ago. Click this box to tell QuickBooks we're going to use this as the income account for billable expenses. Then click the pull down and choose the account that we just created. It's in capitals, it's an income account, income from job supply sales. That's the account that job supplies expense will be transferred into when we bill clients for those supplies. And click Save and Close. Congratulations, you're all set up and we're ready for our first actual example. So let's imagine on March 12th, we paid Staples $400 for job supplies for the Southwoods Road Kirschbaum job, and we paid with check number 86 and we mark it as billable. Well, that's very simple. We already learned we go to the top left and click New and go over to the vendor column and click Check. Now, the date is March 12th and the check number is check number 86. And the payee is Staples Office Supplies. Prefill this check, click No. Just Staples Office Supplies. And the expense that we're actually paying is job supplies expense. So this is the moment we're actually paying the expense. The amount is $400. We check billable, and we know that this is billable to the Kirschbaum job, specifically the Southwoods Road building. Then we click Save and Close. Now let's make sure we recorded this properly. We click Reports and scroll down to Unbilled Charges. And when we click here, we can see that we just properly recorded a charge, which in this case is a check that we paid to Staples, that has not yet been billed to the client. And this is the report that it belongs on. Now, before we bill Kirschbaum for this Southwoods Road job expense, let's take a quick look at the profit and loss by job as a result of just only this check. We click Reports, go down to Profit and Loss by Customer, and if you scroll over to the right and scroll up a little, okay, here's the Southwoods Road building for the Kirschbaum job. Here's the income from the invoices we sent. And here are all of the expenses that we paid related to the Kirschbaum Southwoods Road job. Now you can see job supplies expense has been added as an expense to the Kirschbaum job, lowering the overall profit by $400. So after you pay the money, but before you bill the client, your profit goes down because you paid, you have not billed the client yet for those supplies. So let's now imagine on March 15th, you actually billed Kirschbaum for an additional 20% of the Southwoods Road job, the way you normally would when you made progress for the job. And in this invoice, we're going to add the check for the supplies and bill Kirschbaum for that right at this moment. So how do we do that? Very simple. We click New, go down to Invoice. We know that the date is March 15th, and that the job is the Southwoods Road job under Kirschbaum, and look what comes up in the right. Both the the estimate that we will have to track and follow, as well as the billable expenses to this very same job. And as we learned in a previous video, we first add the information from the estimate by clicking Add. The answer is yes, we are billing for another 20% of the job that we just completed, and click or change it to 20% if yours does not come up 20%. Click Copy to Invoice, and now we have billed Kirschbaum for 20% more of the progress for the job. What we will now do is go to the right panel, and where it says Billable Expense 400, we again click Add, and notice it adds it to the bottom of the invoice, just like all the other items get tracked into income. This will also be tracked into income. Now, I recommend you click for the description, because there's no other way to tell Kirschbaum that this $400 is for job supplies. The text will not transfer over from the description of the check window, unfortunately. So that would help you if you're sending the invoice out. Now when we click Save and Close, we can go back to the Profit and Loss by Job under Kirschbaum, and you can see we now have more income from heating repair, because that was 20% of all the other items, but now we also have $400 more in income that we billed Kirschbaum for. So even though we paid $400 of job supplies expense for Kirschbaum, we also earned $400 from Kirschbaum for the job supplies that he agreed we could bill him for. And that's how you track your income in a separate income account. Here it is, income from job supplies, not the prior one, income from billable expenses. The older one is the default income account. This one is the specific income account that we want to track specific expenses as income when we bill the client.